China is using the WHO to promote its vaccine and buries Russia COVID vaccine. Putin is not going to be very happy about this. The World Health Organization, through its representative at the local office in China, gave its support and understanding to start administering experimental coronavirus vaccines while clinical trials are still underway. Although the WHO chief scientist Soumya Swaminathan said in Geneva this month that national regulatory authorities could approve the use of medical products within their jurisdiction in the current emergency, but described that as a temporary solution. However, this has happened even though Beijing has not released full details of its emergency use program, and as per Economic Times, the WHO representative in China did not immediately entertain requests for comments, solidifying the point that there is some discrepancy and WHO is acting on the wish and whim of the Communist Party of China. There are at least three Chinese vaccine candidates in phase 3 trials, of which two are developed by state-backed China National Biotech Group and the third from Sinovac Biotech, which may as well be state-backed, who knows. On the one hand, these vaccine candidates are getting all the support and understanding from the WHO, and on the other hand, the Russian vaccine has been ghosted by the West, international authorities, as well as the WHO on Chinese behest. How Russia tried to portray and launch its vaccine shows the amount of importance it gave to the vaccine and the diplomacy attached to it. And as the dust settles and people come to know how China has been using the WHO to dismember and bury Russia's Sputnik V vaccine diplomacy, it will become clearer to the international community that all is not well between Sino-Russian relations, and it is not an alliance of all-weather friends as Western media wants us to believe, but it has been an alliance of convenience. The two basic points that even a layman can understand stating the importance of the Russian COVID-19 vaccine program can be laid down as follows. On the one hand, the declaration and the launch day was a sort of national festival in Russia, showcasing hope for the world. It was when Putin got one of his daughters vaccinated to satisfy the obvious curiosity. And on the other hand, the name in itself, the Sputnik V, which signifies the USSR's leaping into space and getting the better of the USA's space program and showcasing to the world the Soviet scientific edge. With all of this, Putin wanted the COVID-19 vaccine to be the Sputnik V moment for Russia. This vaccine was supposed to be Russia's ticket to its old days of glory, and therefore it is very passionate about it. No friend of Russia would work towards destroying what Putin wants to be the game changer so assiduously. And China is no friend of Russia. The Russian scientific technology of fighter jets is of USSR era, and its weapon technology is getting older and older. And now China is hijacking vaccine diplomacy with the assistance of WHO for furthering its interests. This will not sit well with Russia. And Moscow is keeping track of it all. It knows. China wants Russia to play second fiddle to it in the long run, and it was confirmed by a series of events in the last couple years. The Russians complained against China for stealing military technology. It should be seen in the background of the Russians being the largest arms supplier to China with 70% of the market share. In fact, Rostec's chief of intellectual property projects once said, "Unauthorized copying of our equipment abroad is a huge problem. There have been 500 such cases over the past 17 years. China alone has copied aircraft engines, Sukhoi planes, deck jets, air defense systems, portable air defense missiles, and analogues of the Panzer medium-range surface-to-air systems." This is not it. As reported by TFI earlier, Chinese internet users, including diplomats and officials in recent months, have been claiming that Vladivostok used to be part of China. And in response to that, Russia has increased its military buildup in the Far East region, with Russia's defense minister Sergei Shoigu on Thursday iterating that the decision has been taken because of tensions in the eastern strategic direction. He was referring to an area encompassing Russia's eastern border with China and the wider Indo-Pacific. It very well establishes that all is not hunky-dory between Moscow and Beijing, as the Western media would want us to believe and portray everything as black and white, making Russia part of the Chinese evil pole. Russia wants to reclaim its place as a superpower, and it being a realpolitik power, understands China is following its interests at the expense of the Russians. This is the very reason the conflicting interests of these two countries need to be observed closely, and it will be the new theater of conflict in the coming days.